Hello, everyone, and welcome to the first episode calling it Wandering Eorzea. My name is Captain Sarcasm. I will be your VJ and your guide to the adventures of a young warrior of light named... I'm sorry, what? Her name is what? Wandering Clam. That's her name. This whole thing was just an excuse for a pun, wasn't it? Well, I'm under contract, so let's keep going. Here we see Wandering Clam in the opening to the next Kingdom Hearts game. And we are... I don't know, we are on some kind of drug trip, it looks like. We've taken the bad acid. We are just... our minds are drifting through the nether space. Clem, what are you doing? You can't walk on space. Only the Lord Jesus can. You're not muted, Stamp. Who's this asshole? I like his mask. Got a very good sense of style. He seems trustworthy. I think we should go make friends. And then we are consumed by... Whoa! Well, holy shit. Are we the bad guys now? Did we just become Calamity Ganon? Is that what happened? I mean, we kind of look a little bit like Lady Ganondorf. You know, in a good way. Oi! You alright, lass? I'll, of course, be doing the voices since this game didn't bother to. Yeah. You're moaning, you're sleeping, sweating buckets besides. Rolling off the ship got your stomach churling, has it? Hey, doesn't seem like seasickness now that I look at you. It'll be the aether then, I reckon. I don't seem to have a name at the moment. They just call me Grizzled Passenger. Some are more sensitive to the stuff than others, you see. Way too far from Vilbra now, which is just chock full of the Aetherites. No need to fret, though. You'll soon get used to it. Oh, God. Oh, the scotch in my belly. Ugh. Might as well have been blooming seasickness. Ship's leaving around like a demented chocobo today. I reckon I might head out on deck, get myself a breath of fresh air. I mean, Limsa Lomimsa still a fair ways off, in case you were wondering. Seeing as you're awake at all, how's about you keep me company till we get here? And then the saxophone starts playing. Bow-dow. 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 Them young'uns, they don't care much for conversation, see? I don't think they'll be very important. You didn't need to pay too much attention to them. I'm pretty sure they're underage, too. Anyway, Brennan's a name and Pedlin's my trade. It'd be nice if that sentence would rhyme, but, you know, no one has thought of a way to do that. Oh, this is a fancy ship. Are we pirates? I hope we're pirates. Woohoo. And that... ship seems way too high in the water. Is it loaded with a cargo of helium? Doesn't seem like a smell that salty sea breeze. And then he just lets rip the biggest fart anyone's ever heard. Now then, lass, judging by your unusual garments, I'd say you were one of the wandering violet hobos. Am I warm? Yes. It's a very, very significant camera angle there on you, Wander. I knew it! going wherever the wind blows, seeking fortune and glory. Now that's what I call living. So long as you can avoid dying, I mean. Ain't no secret that that being a violent hobo is a risky business, these days especially. Was it that first attracted you to it? Oh, we're getting deep into Wandering Clam's head here. What drives you to wander, Miss Clam? I want power. Power? As in, power to do good? Like, protecting the weak and fighting for what's right and all that? I mean, please? You could, like, kill me in an instant if you decided not to, so please don't. Well, violent hobos get up to a lot of fighting, that's for sure. You'll never be short of a chance to follow up your warcraft in an adventuring business. It's hard to work violent hobo into every sentence, but it makes a lot of sense when you think about it, doesn't it? You'll see as we get more into the lifestyle. Now, once we make port, you best sign yourself up at the Adventurers Guild. They'll set you on the right path. And it wouldn't hurt to join a guild, neither. Limps is home to a few, so if you fancy learning how to swing an axe or even sling a spell, you should think about seeking one out. Just remember, though, there's more important things than fortune and glory, such as breathing. Ain't no profit in being dead, that's a fact. Hey guys, important stuff's happening. Everyone run back and forth across the ship. Oh. Ah. Oh wow, this is starting you off with an epic boss battle. Oh man, that's amazing. We're fighting three pirate ships. Oi, ships off the starboard bow! Pirate colors! This is going to be so cool. We're going to get into a lot of fight things and we're use all our combat. Pirates. Bloody hells. I'm using the wrong accent, I think. Have you no sense? Get below. Alright. And... Wait, is that it? We're not doing the fight scene. Did we not have it in the budget? Is this an episode of Heroes? Ugh, what's this world coming to? Pirates fire on a ship, flying laments and colors. Bastards, you'd have better had a boatload of balls or bugger all for brains. I mean, billions and billions of bilious blue, blistery barnacles. You can rest easy, friends. We've made it out of cannon range, and no buccaneer's bark will catch this flighty temptress once the wind's in her sails. Oh, God. Hey, that was too bleeding close. Glad one of us kept her head on her shoulders. I reckon I'd have lost mine otherwise. And what a loss that would be. I mean, what would this game be without Brennan? If them pirates gave up the chase, we must be close to port. Let's head up on deck and have us a look, shall we? I mean, does anyone else feel cheated? We just bypassed an awesome pirate fight. What even? I mean, I guess it's a nice ship. It would be a shame to ruin it doing the effects shot. What? By the by, is this your first trip to Limsa Laminsa? I think it has, yes. We'd never been to Pyrotropolis before. I'll let this journey to itinerant tell you the ins and outs of your destination. Now, Limsa Laminsa, she prides herself on being Eorzea's naval power. It weren't too long ago that the place was ruled by pirates, but thanks to the current admiral's civilizing influence, the city-state could almost pass for a respectable nation. You'd never guess she was once a rum-swilling buccaneer herself. Of course, most folk ain't so quick to change, and with a town full of liberty-loving ruffians, you can imagine how many naysayers and troublemakers she's got to deal with. Like them pirates who took a fancy to us just now. And if that weren't bad enough, I'd heard that the Sahagin are raiding the coast just as bold as you please. They're a sea-dwelling beastmen the locals call fishbacks, in case you didn't know. I mean, okay, wow, that just strikes me as a really racist name. Anyone else? Ah, long last! Land ho! I like all the background people there. It's nice to see other passengers around, even if it's just a cutscene. Behold, Limsa Lominsa, a nation blessed by the ocean's bounty and beloved of Lilamian, god, the Welsh goddess of navigation. Lilamian. I'm just going to call her Lily. Loading the awesome pirate city. On a windswept isle. In the southwestern corner of the realm. Is this narrated? I can't tell. I'm going to assume it's narrated, alright. What a pretty city.
To this haven for bandits and brigands, cutthroats and curs, seekers of both freedom and fortune, comes a lone adventurer.
I like that commitment to the architecture.
Lone yet not
very nautical.
The hero's arrival has drawn the gaze of the nation's patron deity, Lim Lane.
So we've actually drawn the eye of the god. Wow.
Fate has she descried in the churning waters of this mortal's future.
And here's where we part ways, lass. I'm off to the market to deliver my wares. To deliver my wares, and it's onto the high road for me. Here, I want you to have this, by way of thanks for saving my arse earlier. I have no reaction to this, says Wandering. Hey. You never did tell me your name, did you? Well, here's an idea. You become the sort of storied personage I can brag about having met, and I'll consider a square. How are you going to know that she's the one in the story? You don't even know her name. Are we just going to assume? You're just going to... Whatever. One till sea swallows all. Final Fantasy XIV. What font is that? That's not really the Final Fantasy font, is it? Is that just Helvetica? Did they make the logo for this in Microsoft Word? Oh yes, she's impressed. She likes what she's... I mean, that kind of looks like a safety hazard. I wouldn't trust that not to fall on the plaza. Well, too many sharp bits. Oh, are you there? You. This is my district, and I make it my business to know all the scum that washes up in it. What? Ah, a violent hobo fresh off the boat, is it? Well then. Allow one of Limsa Lominsa's fine path. Hop to it, lass. I haven't got all day. First, you just barely step into the city. You're already getting harassed by police. Welcome to Limsa Liminsa, a bustling city-state filled with scoundrels and brigands, the rough-cut diamond of the Rotano Sea. Please select the control scheme you wish to use. Gamepad. We are definitely going gamepad. Follow the instructions to move your character and adjust the position of the camera. When you're ready to proceed, speak to... You're kidding me. That's his name. Risflow. Sounds like a drain cleaner. Risflow. To be recognized in an adventure in the city-state of Limsa Liminsa, you must first register yourself with the Adventurers Guild. It's a very, very stratified culture. Now then, I'm sure you're itching to explore, but adventurers are required to register their presence in the city. And without a bit of local knowledge, you'll like to get your throat slit in some piss-stinking alley. So before you do anything else, get yourself over to the Drowning Wench and enroll in the Adventurers Guild. Whoop. It's not far. Literally just behind me. Head down the street and speak with Griffar. Griffar? Giraffe. He'll show you how to work that big moving platform we call the Crow's Lift, and that'll take you up to the pub. Once you're there, look for a fellow by the name of Bateron. He's proprietor of the wench. Now, he might curse like an ale-sodden sailor, but the man's got a soft spot for wide-eyed newcomers like yourself. He'll set you straight. Not all that? Good. Run along and may the navigator guide you on your journey. So, one thing will become immediately apparent is that Wandering Clam is the kind of person with no will of her own who will just do whatever the last person she spoke to told her to do. It'll become her sole purpose. We are on the great Zephyr Gate of... Move too fast, Albifar. Gentle wind that... Beyond the great Zephyr Gate of Limsa Liminsa lie the midlands of Lanoska. Gentle wind that passes through the gate is said to be the sweet breath of the gods, carrying life and fortune. Hey, welcome to Limsa Liminsa! You have a mind to finish the drowning wrench? The crow's lift will take you there. The male Roga are like twice as wide as the female. I shudder to think about what reproduction is like. So before we do anything here, can we take a look at wandering for just a second? So it's interesting. We've had this problem with a similar situation with other Roga characters before. They don't seem to fit very well into their own clothes. And I mean, wandering here, but in particular, she looks as though she was a normal person just wearing normal clothes. And then suddenly, the blood transfusion she received from her cousin Bruce Banner kicked in, and she became the sensational She-Hulk, and just completely burst all her clothes at conveniently pre-sewn stress lines. I mean, look at her shirt in particular. It's like 5 sizes too small. I'm not necessarily complaining. I mean, because, I mean, damn. But, I mean, I hope she doesn't get cold. Oh, look at that. Her hair is either clipping right through her giant... that is an ungainly collar. You could windsurf with that. If you popped that, no one would see your head. And yet your hair just clips right through it, or you had to cut a hole, just a slot in the back for your hair. Oh, by the way, honey, are you sure you want to go with the undercut mullet there? That's That's real. Okay, I mean, you know, you do you, but I mean, well, you're tall even for a Roga, are you? Should dodge be? Isn't that a song from the Music Man? Newly come to Limsa Lumimsa, adventurer? Then I suggest you speak with Balduron, the owner of the Drowning Wrench. Wench. Think of him as a guide to our fair city. Seriously, though. Should dodge be. The girl who is hard to get. I can't read any of these words. Greetings to you, lass. what'll it be? Oh, no. You're not here for the drink, are you? You've come with a mind to try your hand at adventuring, I reckon. Well, you'll find no shortage of work here in Limsa. Name's Balduron, and this most hospitable of hostelries is a drowning wench. He's also the home of the Adventurers Guild here in Limsa. That's why we got a desk specifically for handling guild business, and why I seem to spend more time saving the necks of whelps like yourself than wetting the throats of my regulars. Hey, she is hardly a whelp. She is bigger than you. She could break you on her knee. Adventurers have a knack for finding trouble, see? They need in these parts on account of their being trouble wherever you look. You manage to steer clear of the fishbacks and the kobolds outside the city. The pirates on the inside will get you instead. And if they don't manage, there's always the Garlean to finish the job. Oh, no one knows what they're planning, of course. But if they're planning anything, you can bet it's be sure to kill the lot of us. Oh, aye, this town seems peaceful at a glance. But look again, and you'll see a people living in fear what tomorrow might bring. And who can blame them after everything that's happened? Eorzea took a mighty blow during the calamity. But our realms weren't the only things that got wiped off the face of existence by that thrice-damned bastard of a dragon. Took our bleeding memories, too. And no one's been able to explain in a way that makes an ounce of sense. None of the folks what saw it and lived to tell the tale seem to agree on how the tale actually goes. It's all foggy. Like recollections from an hard night in the ale. You can imagine what people might fear for the future if they can't rightly recall the past. There is one thing we all remember, and that's a group of venturers what laid down their lives to back from the brink when she was bound for the abyss. Well, I say we remember. Truth is, though, we ain't forgotten what they did for us. This goddamn calamitous spawn memory loss robbed us of their names. Won't even let us picture the damn faces. It's like staring at a gull flying in front of your eye, flying from the sun, that it just shits right in your eye. That's how every bugger describes it, by the way. Give or take the odd shit. It's this what's got people calling these heroes the Warriors of Light. If Limps is ever going to put this time of darkness behind it, it's going to need ventures to help banish the fear. It's going to need new heroes like the ones. Anyway, though, can I get you some mozzarella sticks? Maybe one day you'll be one of them. That's why we. Any aid we can give to a venture is the effort well spent. And what do you say, lass? You willing to lend us your strength? I mean, I gotta warn you, I'm not giving you even a single free drink. My thanks to you and the navigator and all. I knew she'd steer you my way for a reason. I can just tell. You're going to be way more important to the plot than anyone else I've ever met. Yeah, but... Now, come on. Put your scrawl right there, and your email address, phone number, social security, gonna need a link shell, 3 forms of ID, firstborn child, and I'm wandering clam. That's seriously what you're going with. I mean, really, you could put down any name, just make a new life for yourself. Don't tell me this is the one you're choosing. Come on, please. I believe you can do better. All right. But now you're an upstanding member of the Venturers. Hey, you there, adventurer. You sailed in on the last ferry, did you not? Oh my god, look at that hat. What is she? That's not regulation, lady. We talk to your sergeant. The captain reported being attacked by a pirate vessel, and several witnesses have testified independently that a passenger matching your description went out on deck mere moments before the incident took place. Were you sending your friend signals, were you? It's hard to tell where dialogue is going from the outset sometimes. Now hold on just a moment there, officer. You got the wrong lass. This fine, upstanding young lady is my dear departed grandma's sister's niece's cousin's former roommate. Well, this lass wouldn't be caught dead fraternizing with such unsavory elements. Not here in a bar called the Drowned Wench. Well, is that right? Well, you're surely aware of the recent kidnappings. Respectfully, then, we cannot be too trusting of outsiders at a time when the loyalty of even our closest friends is in doubt. Isn't that right, Corporal Cherrytop? You make a good point there, officer. A very good point. Very wise. You needn't worry, though. I keep one eye open at all times, me. 2 more often than not. When I'm sober, you know, that is. I mean, do have that alcoholism, but I'm fine. What do you say to a tankard of my finest ale before you return to your duties? Not a watered-down cup of piss like last time, I should hope. Oh no, you're getting 100% piss this time. Now, the wench might offer some of the cheapest grog this side of the Strait of Marathor, but that don't mean it won't get you good and pickled. Hey, look, there's a chair over there just crying out to be sat on. Well, kick off them heavy boots, huh? I mean, they seemed really easy to give up their investigation. I'll have to excuse these eager, bloody yellow jackets. There's been a spate of kidnapping, see? And they ain't got a clue who's behind him. Naturally, they've taken the clapping irons on anyone who looks vaguely suspicious. Which means venturers, visitors, pretty much every bugger else in this town. Don't take it personal, though. Slaminsons can be an headstrong bunch of bastards, true. But given time, we'll grow on you. You know, like a rash. Now, where was I? Oh, that's right. Welcome to Limsa Limimsa, where the sea's as green as the faces of my patrons after a few too many Black Bella whiskeys. You're sure to get murdered in at least 5 different ways here. Now, take a moment to gather your wits, and we'll get to learning you about the city. And somehow, that gives you money. He just gave you 50 gold. I mean, Balduron 10 fingers. Is that... I would think a lot of people have 10 fingers. It's like saying Balduron walks on 2 legs. Balduron has all his skin. Balduron, proprietor of the Drowning Wench, wants you to fulfill three tasks that will let you become a real pirate. Oh god, this is... We're in Monkey Island right now, isn't it? Sorry, I'm just... I have to look something up. Alright then. Let's start you off nice and easy with three tasks. What'll help you get used to life here in Limsa? So, first, if you're head down a floor, then point your nose to the west. You'll get an eyeful of the green of the great glowing crystal in the middle of the courtyard. That's an aetherite, a device that can move you from one place to another in the blink of an eye. Ain't no swifter way to travel. Have a chat with the... Provide there's an aetherite where you want to go, of course. Have a chat with the yellow jacket on guard down there. You'll be treated to a lecture on the workings of the device. Before you do that, though, remember to touch the thing. Strange as it sounds, it won't work till you have. Which means you can't go somewhere unless you've already gone somewhere. Which, I mean, really, that seems like a design flaw. They should have patched that out. Now, the second on the list is a marketplace. You'll find weapons and armor and all your venturing bits and pieces for sale in the district what lies beyond the aetherite. Don't go throwing your gill around just yet, or you'll get fleeced quicker than you can say, "Why is my coin purse so light?" Have a word with... You're making these names up. Swazblate? With Swazblate instead. He's at the Merchants League, by the way. Give him this old octant, and he'll treat you well. For the last mailful ints, I suggest you meet some fellow axe wielders at the Marauder's Guild. That's literally all you need to get in. Possessing an axe. Guarantee you'll learn a few new tricks for swinging that Ed Splitter of yours if you join their crew. Blathola at the front desk is the one to get you started. Got all that, lass? Now, seeing them three tasks will take you on a little jaunt around the city and help you work out where everything is. Now I'd best be getting on. Run along, eh? Bugger, there I go, send you off with that crucial. That bloody calamity's made a right mess of my memory, huh? Well, that of the ale. Any road, while you're out, if you happen to pass any poor sods what look like they got giant glowing punctuation over their heads, you consider giving their tale of woe a listen, huh? Sounds like a chore, I admit, but you never know what interests and opportunities could be lurking out there, just waiting for you to stumble on them. Example, Ninya over there has yonder been casting glances at you since you waltz in. Wanna buy her a drink, you might get lucky. Come on. You know she wants it. You know she wants some of that Roga. Once you build your reputation as a woman folk can trust, jobs get harder, but the reward to get more generous. Oh, and if you have the time, I'd also seek the advice of the smith over there in the wench. The lads as bear that title have some fine advice for one of them. For them, what are just... It's... The old-timey grammar is very difficult to read. It just... For them, what are just starting out in the profession. And that, my girl, is how you go about becoming a legend among adventurers. Okay, so if I remember this from Monkey Island, first you have to go, you have to practice insult sword fighting, then you have to find the treasure of Melee Island, and then you have to steal a treasure from the Governor's Island. If its rumors are like mine to tell as you seek, then you have made the right choice in coming to this tavern. It's a lodestone for all manners of travelers and explorers. Oh my god, look at his face. He looks like a blonde... What's the guy's name? The asshole from... forget it. No seafarer as a bloke meets a rougher and a barnacled hull, but these laments and scrags are something else. Suppose I should expect not less from a city what was founded by pirates. Ramsay Bolton, that's the name I was thinking of. It's like a blonde Ramsay Bolton. Yeah, yeah, do them squats. Do them squats, girl. And you there, just... you eat your apple. Or bread roll. I don't know. Why are you eating it with mittens on? Ninia. Ninia, a veteran adventurer, has some information that might be of interest to you. Can we zoom in? Well, would you look at this? A shiny new adventurer. Listen close, lass. I have some information that just might help put you on the map here in Limsa. I was passing through Bulwark Hall not long ago and saw a bunch of herbs just scattered on the ground. Now, I'm not entirely certain, but I think they might have been the black market wares known as Dreamflower. Limsa Laminsa is a busy port, and not all the merchants that blow in across the strait are above board, if you know what I mean. How'd the plants end up at the mizzenmast? Who knows, might have been a deal gone bad. The important thing is you make a name for yourself by handing them in. Speak to Skeinrail, and she'll get you down to the first floor. Then all you have to do is pick up the herbs and take them to... Aldskiff at the Octant. Being a worldly captain, he knows a thing or two about such shady goods. So, our first quest in this game is... we just got tricked into being a drug mule. That's what happened here. I mean, they say it's on the up and up, but would they tell you if it wasn't really... You want to visit Bulwark Hall below? The crow's lift is ready when you are. You know, you could just use the stairs. It's only one floor. Is you have to learn how to pick something up. It's a very important skill. Just... we wouldn't know how to do that special thing with our knees. Quest. Okay, seriously, what is going on? Why are they just in a neat line like this? Was a drug dealer lost in the woods and trying to find his way home? Was that it? Did Heisenberg try to sell Walter Jr. to a witch? What? And then they just... what kind of drug dealer just leaves their drugs lying around? Oh my god! Oh, this is my new favorite character. I love him. Alright. Yeah, that's right. I'm old as skiff. Yeah, you got the stuff for me? You know... special stuff. A common weed rumored to have relaxing properties when either ingested or smoked. Wink, wink. Oh yeah, yeah, it's dream flowers. Of course, you know this is highly illegal, and the prime ingredient in the creation of Somnus, a substance whose fragment is said to lure the sniffer's mind into the sleep of death. But, you know, I would never be involved with this highly illegal... these herbs are nothing but lavender, a common enough export from Limsa Laminsa. I mean, these crates could have come from any ship. No need to go searching specific ones. Oh, someone is playing a joke on you, miss. Oh, don't worry. You've learned that these are not drugs. I'll contact you if I need any more. So, are we actually taller than this guy? It certainly looks like we're taller. Ah, Argog, don't, you'll blend your DNA with him. Haven't you seen the fly?
Aldous Skiff, captain of the trading ship Orion, has some information that might benefit your...
By way of thanks for delivering my scattered lavender, I have a nugget of information which may prove useful to you. See, I was recently approached by an unkempt seafarer, which, I mean, it's not particularly unusual for a man in my profession. We can't groom our mustaches 5 times a day like you city folk. What was unusual was that he offered a generous sum of gild to be introduced to any adventurers. Now, in my experience, sailors are not known to carry such a wealth of coin about their person, especially with the alehouses of Limsa Lamimsa so close at hand. Kidnappings haven't been uncommon these past moons. I say you take this information and speak with Glazrael. Oh my god, it's the Angel of Death, Glazrael! The guard who stands at the entrance to East Hawker's Alley. Never hurts to show a spirit of cooperation to the authorities, lass. Throws them off your scent. And remember, if you ask them if you're a cop, they have to say yes. Oh yeah, I'm the hired captain of the Orion. She's a fine vessel, but a hired captain can love his ship only as much as a paid bride can love her betrothed. Oh, okay, that got dark. A ship of my own is all I've ever wanted. Was a gill away from buying one when the calamity struck. Oh, but how can I complain when so many lost so much more?
I mean, this far in, though, we're already talking about mail order brides in a Final Fantasy game. What? Well, I don't even know. All right, well. Tiki Diamante, nice dancing. Got some moves on her. What? Glazrael.
That is disturbing news. Your initiative is appreciated, adventurer. I'll have the captain place the yellow jackets on high alert. And while I have your ear, I need you to visit Fridwib and tell her the same thing you told. You'll find her a bit further down East Hawker's Alley. Fridwib has frequent dealings with adventurers, so any warning you give her should soon spread through the city.
Some nice eyes, very piercing. But don't forget we have a main quest back there. We'll just take our time and explore the city. It's very lovely this time of always.
Greetings, miss. Might I interest you in the services of a retainer? What's this? Some suspicious seafarers on the prowl for gullible adventurers? Possible suspect of the recent kidnappings, you think? Well, I'll be sure to pass that on that warning to my customers.
What, assuming they can pay attention to anything I'm saying while I'm wearing this outfit.
What with all the merchants and travelers milling through Hawker's Alley? These kinds of unsavory activities can often go unnoticed. It seems like people are very distracted for some reason. I can't imagine it. Anyway, I promise to keep a sharp lookout for anyone being accosted by strange-looking sailors.
Okay, you got dark matter? What? Why are you holding dark matter? That's not even been proven to exist yet. It's only a theoretical possibility to explain a mathematical imbalance in the universe. What is going on?
It has recently been discovered that a substance of unknown origin has the faculty to assimilate with other forms of matter, effectively restoring them to their original condition.
What? What? How do...
I think Stephen Hawking's head just exploded.
Yes, that is a nice outfit she has. Oh, look at that purple hair. Wow, he's rocking that. Oh my god, he's got purple hair and the Harry Potter glasses. Oh my god. Oh, no. This is my new favorite character. Oh. Fine day to you, madam. Welcome to the most replete marketplace in the grand realm of Eorzea, where every shelf groans under the weight of wonders born from all four corners of the world. Pray, browse the stalls until your eyeballs ache from ogling the overabundance of unbelievable bargains. Now, as much as I would love to elaborate on the unrivaled quality of our merchandise, I must tend to some cargo but recently arrived at the docks. Huh? Oh, you got a gift from Balderon! Oh, whatever could it... Ah! My octant! By the navigator, I must have left it behind in the wench, along with a week's pay and several bells worth of intoxicated memories. I mean, an instrument widely used in maritime navigation. This one appears to have been a victim of the elements. So I'm assuming it's like a sextant, but with two more. I don't even know why a sextant is called that, or if it involves sex or sixes. Oh, I am most grateful to have it back. This tool is a keepsake from my days as a ship captain, you see. Needless to say, your good deed must be repaid, and what better recompense than the wisdom of a master merchant? I don't know, how about some money? Could you give us some money? Or a hat, maybe? If it is simple and sturdy adventuring equipment, you need look no further than the east and west arms of Hawker's Alley. Lest you doubt, each gil you invest in arms and armor will be money well spent. Adventuring is, after all, a dangerous profession by its very nature. Goes without saying that Hawker's Alley boasts stalls specializing in every martial discipline imaginable, and by that we mean the ones that you can learn in this city. And within but a few steps are bazaars and apothecaries that will most amply supply all your potion and perishable needs. Our keen-eyed agents procure a frankly befuddling range of wares during their sojourns to distant shores. I mean, seriously, I cannot even explain it. It will drive you mad trying to fathom it. Such knowledge will serve you well if your purse is light or your time is short. But verbal instruction of this kind will only profit you so much. Experience has ever been the surest teacher, if not the kindest. I invite you to explore the markets for yourself. And by that I mean, I'm going to ask you to do my shopping. Oh my god, is that One Punch Man over back there? Kaiser Bov... Yeah. Look at him, he's... If he was bald, he would make a perfect Saitama. Oh my god, his hair though, that's... Everyone here has the best hair. Except you. I mean, you're... Oh, Tika's still dancing. Yes, just let the crystal have a tiny bit of your soul. Ah, another novice adventurer. I say, having no idea what person will look like. Aye, Balderon has sent more than a few of your kind this way of late. Oh! Joe's completely the wrong voice. I'm Sandemal, one of the Yellow Jackets tasked with keeping the peace in the city. It's also my charge to provide guidance in the use of this device. Now fear not, I'll be brief. Aetherites are crystalline structures that tap into ethereal energies, primarily used as a means to travel swiftly from one place to another. Return and teleport, the most common transportation spells. Make direct use of the Aetherites and their connection to the flow of Aether. Is it Aether or Ether? I don't know. These devices are found in almost every corner of Eorzea. Any adventurer worthy of the name will wish to seek out and attune herself to each one. Got that? All of them. Don't get all of them? You have failed. Once you have expanded your horizons beyond the walls of the city, you'll soon find yourself performing the act of attunement as a matter of course. and just waltz right into areas 5 levels above you just for that sweet, sweet attunement. Of course, there is no need for unseemly haste. The aetherites found in and around the city will be sufficient for the present, I assure you. But do you want to learn more about aetherites or magic? I'll be here to answer your questions. You turn with the aetherite. You can now use the return spell. Even though you already seem to have it. You have to press a button for auto attack? That's awkward. Oh. It's very busy tonight. I can't even read everyone's name. They're all just merging with each other. You go have fun, Yojimbo. Monocat Pretty Pots. I mean, points for committing to the theme. Oh my god, she's so tiny. This doesn't come up to your boobs, wandering. Oh, and look, there's jiggle physics. That's a thing now. I don't know if I should comment on it or not. Shiki Scarlet. Nice. I like that hat. Oh my god, look, those two there. They're having a moment. Oh, it's so sweet. Anyway, yes, what shall we do next? I ask, even though I really have no way of communicating with Wandering. I can't even hear her. Looks like we're trying to find all the other Ethernet shards. Or Ethernet. Or whatever. When we find them here, we'll be able to teleport to any other shard, which will give us instant access to other parts of the city, which will immediately put all forms of public and private transportation out of business. I mean, it's a wonder that the government even lets us live. You'd think the unions would have something to say about this. My loins throb like Dalamond. My heart burns like Megaflare. Oh, well, that's a smooth line, sir. I may have to on the off chance I'm ever talking to a woman. I mean, prison company, except, but I mean, you're just a video game. Anyway, don't seem to know where we're going. Do the ones we haven't found yet show up on the map at all? Oh god, don't get between them. Look, he may be crap at it, but they're still trying to make their relationship work. Oh good, they do show up on the map. That's great. And there's the Marauders Guild all the way up there. Yes, they're just talking about fish. Stop eavesdropping. Come on. You're the Warrior of Light, you should be better than this. You gotta set an example for all the children. I'm not sure what tune this is supposed to go to. When you're seeking someone for a feat you need done, to the Ventures Guild you be calling. No deed beyond there, so long the coin be fair, to the graves be the Ventures fallen. That's a morbid song for their national anthem, don't you think? Is everyone here just completely immune to their own mortality? Just the sea breezes of limps and limps are
Quite a dramatic difference in the salty winds of Ulda. Oh no, no, I must remain detached, focused. I'm here, you see, to survey the extent of the calamity's damage. Oh, but I often find myself overwhelmed by the unfamiliar sensations of this barbaric yet fascinating city. Yes, well, screw you too, Yiwazu. I mean, you know, we may be pirates, but we're not barbarians. Come on. Oh, yes, yes, we're going to see him kill a cop. Come on, do it, do it, do it, do it. Want to see some blood? Want to see some blood? I mean, no, I mean, they're not going to do it. They're just going to keep shouting at each other. All right. There's almost too much in the incidental dialogue to repeat it all. Okay, so, can we back up and get like a good view of this building? All right, well, we've accessed the Ethernet, that's something. Oh, huh. For a second, I thought it would be taller. Wow, that's quite... I mean, that's quite the decoration they have there. They got the axe and the rifles that... I don't even think you can use in this game. I don't think you can use rifles. You have to get at least an expansion pack, and even then, I think you only get, like, fancy pirate pistols. Oh, see, now that over there, that's a tall building. Someone important must live there. We should rob it and steal all its stuff. Because pirate. Coral Tower. Ho there, adventurer. Curious about the Marauders Guild, are you? Any axe worth swinging needs two hands on the haft and has a blade what can make short work of a galley's mast. That's the kind of weapon our members train to use with deceptive swiftness and all too predictable force. You interested in hearing more, lass? You want to come in and see a dead body? Why don't they give you the short version of the guild's found in history, and we can go from there. It all started with ships, you see. What a ship's got to do with axes, you ask? Shut up, bitch. I'm talking. Now, building them would be pretty bloody difficult without a sturdy tool to lop down trees for timber. And since only the navigator herself knows when a ship will run afoul of a storm or worse, it makes sense for the crew's carpenter to carry an axe on board. That's right. It all started with shipbuilding and ship repair. Oh, what? Am I boring you, maggot? Or are you going to sit here and listen? As I was saying, any tool on a ship can become a weapon, and the axe was perfect for hooking yourself over the rail of an enemy, letting loose in a whirl of steel, and generally laying waste all about you. As more seafarers took up the axe as their weapon of choice, so did the bloody art of the Marauder begin to take shape. Specifically among pirates, where strength and skill decided your place in the world. With an eye to assembling crews of battle-ready raiders, the pirates started preaching the proper way to wield a chopping blade to their new recruits. And that's how the Marauders Guild first came to be. But, you know, once a Galadian Accord was signed to unite the Maelstrom and the pirates against Limps' enemies, just went all downhill ever since the fucking merger. I mean, the Accord was a dismal failure. You know, the first version just did not work out at all. But, you know, they came around, they took everything out, they put in, you know, completely new engine. The second version worked so much better. Oh, just completely reborn. I mean, the members of this new guild, they weren't any greed-driven cutthroats either. They were warriors who sought to use their martial prowess for the good of society. If mastering the axe is your heart's desire, then you'll find no better arena in which to practice your swings. Think it over, and let me know if you fancy joining our ranks. I have a feeling I'll be seeing a lot more of you. Oh, you decided to swing an axe with the Marauders, then.
Lethola wishes you to reaffirm your desire, because, you know, just once is never enough for this girl.
All right, then. All that needs doing now is to speak with the Axe Master himself. Sounds simple. I've seen folks slink out the door rather than put themselves in the path of that unnerving glare. That's a bloke right there in the middle of the room. Wyrn Zoen's his name. Put some steel in your spine and look him straight in the eye when you talk to him, lass. Good fortune to you.
So, I mean, that's a really elaborate background for just, we swing axes at people. Oh my god,
he's got eyebrows under his eyes.
And an awesome mustache. Oh, everyone here has such great facial hair. The facial hair just can do no wrong. Oh my god, what is that? How do you even use that? Is that even an axe anymore? I mean, I don't even think it has an edge, it's just got spikes. What even is that? Does it have a hinge? Does it fold down and then open up? Is it a transforming axe? I don't understand what I'm seeing. Oh, it's another one with those nice hats. That's a comfort in these dark times. She is so tiny. Tiny little cat person. What is going on?
Alright, hang on. I need to get in the voice for this one. I heard Jim Yod.
Hey, I'm Will Zoen. The Axe Master, they call me. Not the most imaginative of titles, I agree. But one should not underestimate the value of directness. I welcome your interest in our guild.
Oh, the art of the...
I'm going for pirate, but it comes off more Scottish. Scottish seems to be my default.
Oh. Ernajim Yed. The art of the Marauder is used to rend, to cleave, and to destroy. It's not our way to simply outfight our adversaries. We seek to overwhelm them!
The Marauder must be the most powerful and enduring presence on the battlefield.
We must account for the most enemies defeated. Our role in combat is that of a steel whirlwind, aye. Dealing death and destruction without equal.
No doubt the question has already been put to you by Blathola, but once more shall I challenge your commitment. Are you prepared for the bloody carnage that awaits as an initiate of the Marauder Guild? I think yes. I think we're very much into the carnage. That's what we came here for.
Ah, so be it then. Aye, what be your name?
Wandering? Alright, whatever.
Now hold fast to this moment of dedication. The path of the Marauder is a jagged and perilous one. The blood that spills at your feet will oft-times be your own. You stand now as a student of the axe. Let us waste no time in testing the edge of your chosen weapon. You shall wade straight away into combat as befits a novice of our discipline. Go forth and say the beaten, scurrying, crawling pests that plague the outskirts of Limsa Laminsa. Lost lambs, wharf rats, and little ladybugs shall be your piteous adversaries this day. Return to me once three of each creature have fallen to your blade.
You know, I really should have practiced a pirate voice before today. Oh, that'll teach me to go into this blind. The Yellow Jackets used to be part of the Knights of the Barracuda, but we were swallowed into the maelstrom during the Calamity. Our voyage through the maelstrom has hardened both our steel and our resolve. Oh, the poor cat person of indeterminate gender. I'm going to say girl because of the pigtails, but I mean girl. Yeah, probably girl. Just can't find anything. And look, half the shelves. Oh, she can't reach. She's trying to reach one. Wandering, get the book off the high shelf for her. Oh, that poor girl. Get her a stepladder at least. Something. Anything. Please. I can't. Arr, Jim lad. Arr. No, I used. I can only do it on Talk Like a Pirate Day. I'm worthless any other day. Yar, har, fiddle-dee-dee, being a pirate is all right with me. Do what you want, because a pirate with three is free. You are a pirate. Oh, wow, someone's already asking you to join a free company. Huh. You're popular. Word is spreading out. Now you'll have two free companies to tell about about this show. Yo-ho, yo, pirate's life for me. Oh my god, she's got a pet Araman and bunny ears. Go. Oh, she left. She was dressed like Arthur from Fate Stay Night. Ah, there you are. Enjoy your jaunt around the city, did ya? If you mean to base yourself in Limsa Lamimsa, that won't be the last time you visit them three places. Now you got some idea what's where, you can start exploring the rest of the town. Ah, you've shown a good ear for listening. Stick with old Balderon and you'll go far.